Well, joining us is the latest re-signing for the Dundee Stars. It's Jake Elmer. Jake, fans ecstatic to have you back for the 24-25 season. We are as well. How excited are you about it?
Yeah, I'm fired up. You know, we had some discussions with Mark and talked to my family, talked to my agent, kind of decided what would be the best opportunity for me moving forward for my career and, you know, what would be a good spot for me to just have a good year. And I, you know, it always came back. I really, really enjoyed my time in Dundee, and leaving was, you know, I was a little sad to leave. So I'm excited to be coming back and, you know, getting ready to be back in the DIA, rocking and rolling again.
Let's reflect on that a little bit. Of course, I'm sure you had offers from many places at the end of the season. What was it always in your mind once you'd got back home and reflected a bit that you wanted to try and get back to the Dundee Stars if it was possible?
Yeah. I just wanted to get away from the game for a little bit when the season ended. When I got home, I went for vacation with my family, and we went down to Mexico, just kind of got away from everything. And so it was nice for me to get, you know, kind of my mind away from the game and decide what I wanted to do and where I wanted to go and what would be a good opportunity for me. And I told Mark and I told other people that, you know, I wouldn't say absolutely not, I'm coming back, but I'm not going to say yes, I'm coming back, right? And so I wanted to just, you know, see what was out there. But, you know, Dundee was awesome. I really enjoyed everything about it. And, you know, hopefully we get some more guys back and get some new guys in that are going to be really help our team quite a bit. And yeah, I'm just excited to get back and see all the boys.
Yeah, you mentioned that there about, you know, taking your time to think about things and not just committing to something, which is always the best way, I always feel. But I suppose even when coaches hear that, sometimes they must think, yeah, that guy's not coming back. What was Mark like when you'd kind of had those final discussions and the deal was kind of sealed?
Yeah, we just both exclaimed how excited we were for the year, how it's going to be fun working together again. You know, I think we're going to have a good team this year. I think we're going to be, you know, a contender. And I think that, you know, with the personnel that we've already brought back and who we could possibly bring in. And, you know, there's a lot of guys that are really good players that would be big beneficial parts to our team. And obviously, if we get some guys from last year back, that would help too. So, yeah, I mean, we're both excited. We're ready to rock. And I'm just going to do my job here and he's going to do his there. And we'll meet up in Dundee soon.
And I'm sure when you were in Mexico, you were keeping tabs on the Dundee Stars and noticing a few of your teammates from last year re-signing. Was that a big part of it, knowing that you had built relationships and friendships with those guys?
Yeah, it definitely made it a much easier decision. You know, Pools was my roommate since he got to Dundee. And, you know, we got along really well. And I think it'd be awesome to live with him again and see him. And so that definitely helped and made it a lot easier. And, you know, just the being comfortable around the guys. You don't come into a locker room, don't know anybody, and have to, you know, build those relationships all over again. It's kind of already set there. You know, our chemistry's going to get better. We're going to get more, you know, comfortable with each other on the ice and know where guys are going to be because you've just played more with them. So, yeah, I'm really excited to see the guys, and I think it'll be a really good experience for all of us to be on a team kind of as a core and, you know, stick together this year. So it's exciting.
And we could talk about you personally from last season and maybe your time at the Stars as well. But let's talk about the Elite League, because when you had signed for the Stars, of course, you know, I know you made due diligence checks and you knew about the league. What was that experience like playing in the Elite League last year once you really got into it?
Yeah, you know, I started the season off in Denmark. It didn't go the way we wanted it to go. And obviously I got the opportunity to come to Dundee. So, you know, I was open-minded. I was ready to rock. I wanted to, you know, come in and make an impression. And the impression was made the first game preseason in Fife, where I went, holy crap, this rink is a lot different than what I've ever played in. So that was a good eye-opener. But, you know, it's awesome. The league's really good. It's getting better every year. You know, I was really impressed with our fans, with even other teams' fans, you know, the support that they're getting. So it's exciting to see people are, you know, getting more interested in hockey. And I think that's just going to do better for the league every single day. So, yeah, it was an eye-opener, but it turned out to be an unbelievable experience.
We do joke about that sometimes at Stars TV, thinking if a guy's first game is in a one of these smaller arenas like a Fife, you know, what are they thinking? Or if their first game's in Belfast and then they hop across and the next game's in Fife or Manchester, what was genuinely going through your mind when you arrived in that arena that night, if you're being honest? Were you, oh my gosh, what have I done? Or what was the situation?
It was we pulled in, I can't say it on here, yeah, it was a lot of question marks, and I was like walking in the locker room and like seeing there's no glass along the sides and the penalty box situation there. I mean, I like playing in that rink. It's a good energy and it's like good ice, so it's a good spot to play. But holy crap, like I couldn't do it. I was shocked. Let's just say.
As the season goes on, you know, you get into the DIA, which has been packed every single game last season, and incredible support from the fans. And even through the tough times, you know, the fans never went away last year. The numbers continued to grow and the noise was always there. And I suppose it is that special, I say it's a special club in the Elite League, not being biased, but it is because of the closeness, I would say, of the fans, the ownership and the players. Everyone's all one. And the Dundee Stars, it's a smaller organisation trying to achieve big things. But I suppose it's very unique in comparison to the Sheffields, the Nottinghams of the league, the Belfasts, where, you know, they're different, I suppose, entities in terms of their arena and such like. Is that something that you enjoyed, Jake, as the season ended, knowing that you were part of a close family and community like that?
Yeah, it's cool. You know, the arena, we kind of looked around the year and we thought about like what is a good way to describe the rink. Like we joked about it, or you know, we're just chatting about it, and I think it came up to just like it's an intimate experience when you're at the rink. You know, you see people that you see on a regular basis every weekend. You see people, you know, coming to our practices, seeing people within the city, so it, you know, you get to see the familiar faces, have conversations with people and get to know them. It's exciting. You don't see that very often in pro hockey, so it's cool. And then, yeah, obviously the fans during the year were amazing. You know, we had some tough stretches. I mean, we were, you know, questioning things too, going, what the heck's going on? But, you know, that's just part of playing pro hockey and pro sports in general. You know, you're going to have ups and downs. And I give credit to the fans because they stuck by us and they kept coming to the games. And, you know, they supported us, they picked us up. And I think a lot of it too, they could see the energy that our team had. Is, you know, if you saw us in practice, the way that we just kind of bonded and connected, and then on the ice too, you know, guys are having a tough day, guys are picking each other up, you know, defending each other's teammates, being hard to get play against. I think they built around our team, and it was really cool experience to kind of be a part of. And I think part of the reason why I wanted to come back is I wanted to experience that again and maybe build on that and see, you know, see where we could go by the end of the season.
Yeah, we'll talk about the team and last season, I suppose, overall in a minute. One thing we must give a shout out is or two is the OSC, who bring that traveling support. Some of the best games of the season for me stick out with the away supports, and especially in Glasgow at the end of the season. You know, when they made trips to Cardiff, the Fife games, of course, you know, that
Fife games are good.
We've not bashed their arena, but we've maybe critiqued it. But yeah, but certainly some memorable nights there.
You can critique it, but it was awesome. Like that rink is fun to play in. Like it's a good night when you're playing there.
Yeah, exactly. And it's not too far away as well, which brings our fans. But just how good is it when you've got the traveling support like you did, and especially on occasions where we were able to create memories last season, you know, and have those highlight key games that we all remember as kind of standout moments?
Yeah. I mean, obviously, like you go into a rink, you know, it's going to be loud, and it just gives you kind of an extra boost when you have your crowd cheering for you in the away rinks. So, yeah, during the playoff games there in Cardiff, you know, we had our supporters there, and it was super cool to see in our warm-ups that there's a bunch of people around the glass, you know, asking for pucks and showing us the pictures or artwork or glasses or whatever they've got going on for us. So it was cool to see the support. You know, it kind of makes it not as intimidating to play on an away game, but it just gives you a bit more comfortability when you're out there knowing that you got, you know, somebody in your corner kind of thing. So it's cool. It means a lot to us.
Yeah, and that's not always the case when you go to some of the English teams on a Wednesday night. You can expect, or Belfast on a Wednesday, you're not expecting there to be masses of people. What's some of the arenas you enjoyed playing? I know you've just said Fife there is an incredible one. What's some other away arenas you enjoyed playing in last year? Maybe some you hated playing in.
Yeah, I liked Belfast. Belfast rinks are nice. It's a cool city. I don't know. I liked playing in Cardiff just because it's like it's a good energy game and we just had battles against those guys. So that was kind of my most fun rink to play in. And obviously, like, Sheffield's pretty dope because it's big and they've got a lot of people there. But I think my favorite, I think, was Cardiff.
That's nice.
Because that game was always a big game. Even if it was like the score was differential, like 8-2 or whatever it might have been, or if it was 6-5, like it was. That game was a fun game to be in.
Absolutely. Yeah. You know what? These are the key games. It's when you reflect back at the end of the season, thinking, what things do you remember from the season? It's always those games, isn't it? They come back how did you feel at the end of the season? Was there a sense of hurt at the end when you didn't achieve the aim of reaching that final four and getting to Nottingham in that playoff final four?
Yeah. Obviously, it's like your season's done. It kind of sucks because it's the realization that, like, you know, you're going to be done for a little while. Maybe for me personally, I was kind of on a little streak. I was doing well, so I kind of wanted to continue the momentum. But, it sucked. I mean, obviously, we didn't beat Cardiff all year, and we were pretty hung up on that. We really wanted to beat them. It was just unfortunate the way it turned out. I mean, I don't love the aggregate series, but I appreciate the games that they're exciting. They're battles, and then, you know, our home game was an awesome game to be a part of too. So, yeah, obviously it was a disappointing, left a sour taste in my mouth. So that's why I'm coming back to maybe redeem that. So yeah, we'll see.
You talk about not being a fan of that aggregate score thing. Do you think that's? And I know why. There's loads of debates and fans go on about it. You know, coaches, players, everybody goes on about the structure of the Elite League. And it is slightly different. Do you think that's the benefit of having a good number of returning players? Because they know how important everything is in the Elite League. They know the structure and the setup. And I suppose you can hit the ground running.
Yeah. I think that plays a role. You have guys that are comfortable. It just makes your job a little bit easier knowing how to do the job, I guess. So, I don't know if it's necessarily better or worse. It's just personal preference. I like a series, like a longer series where maybe you don't have a great game two, and, you know, you can build off that, whatever. But it worked out fine. It's a good experience, and I think the guys are going to be that have experienced it last year and know what it's all about are going to be a little bit more hungry and just have a better understanding of it. So I think it'll be exciting.
Let's get away from hockey talk for a bit. Let's talk about Scotland and your time there. You mentioned golf, of course, is one of your favourite things. Ideal location to play golf, right? Even though you were still playing it way after the season finished.
Yeah.
So what was your highlights of last season in Scotland, non-hockey related?
Non-hockey related. Well, you know, I golfed a lot. Well, not a lot, but I golfed a good amount with the guys, and you know, we got to experience some of the really cool courses there. So that was super exciting. As a big golf fan myself, you kind of be in awe when you've never been in to, you know, St. Andrews, to the old course or whatever. And when you get there, it's kind of just this big moment, and it's cool. And it's kind of surreal to that we were living 15 minutes from there and people could ask me how I was doing and see where I was at. And I'll be like, man, I'm right at St. Andrews. I get to go walk that place whenever I want. So that's definitely a moment that was a big thing that I really enjoyed, was going there and going to the other golf courses and spending time with my teammates. I like the city. I love going out and seeing all the pubs and seeing all the other cool spots and restaurants and, you know, just getting a feel for, you know, what locals of Dundee get to do. And I really try to involve myself in being around, you know, when I'm playing in a city, I like to do stuff in the city. So it was a super cool experience for me, you know, hanging out with the guys. That was the biggest thing for me, was building camaraderie, building relationships, and I found it really easy with the team we had last year.
Any good haunts or places that you're missing right now that you enjoyed in Dundee that you can?
I miss Clark's Bakery. I miss stopping and getting a Scotty breakfast wrap or a couple donuts here and there late at night. So that place was really nice. It's really close to my apartment or my flat, sorry. And that's probably the spot I miss the most. That was an easy breakfast place if I wasn't feeling making it.
Was that if you were to go, your go-to thing in Clark's, if you can only pick one thing, what would have you went for? Or what would you go for?
Ooh, my order would probably be like the spicy Caesar salad wrap, and then I'd get 2 jam donuts. And if I was feeling crazy, I'd get a Ribena, but if not, a blue Powerade. That was my order if it was post-practice.
Like it. Did you go to any gigs or anything when you were in Scotland last year?
No, I didn't. I really wanted to. Every time I go into a couple coffee shops, I'd see posters of little music events or whatnot, but I never went, and I was pissed about it too when I look back, but I'm sure I'll try to get out to a couple more of those.
Yeah, you have to go big next time, Jake. Not a couple of events in Dundee. You have to go to like the Hydro, get to Glasgow and do some stuff. Come on. It's all about Bakers.
That's true. I should get out more. I should get out of my little bubble for sure. But that's perfect. I got another 9 months to do that when the season starts.
You have. I think you've covered a lot of it already, but what is the aim for you this season? Is it to get the Dundee Stars to that Final Four, make a Challenge Cup final? I know that whole format's changed, and that's something for all of us to enjoy for the start of the season. But yeah, we'll get confused about that over the next few weeks and months. But is it just the case of trying to get to that Challenge Cup final and get to the Final Four?
Yeah, I mean, we want to lift trophies. If we could lift 3, that'd be fantastic. But, we're going to try to make the Final Four. That's our ultimate end goal, to lift the finals playoff trophy there. And we want to be a contender. We want to be top 3, top 5 in the league. And I think we have the personnel right now to do it. And then we'll see who we add and what Marks wants to bring to us and how we can build the team to be, in the next maybe 2 years, be, number one team in the league and win some trophies hopefully this year too. That'd be fantastic.
Now, Jake, I know we talked about it off camera, but fans will ask me what this room is that you're in. It looks like maybe like with the pipes above you, like it's a 1970s hospital from a horror movie or something. So could you clarify what that is? I know you've got your gaming chair. Is it the gaming room? What is it?
Yeah, it's my mental asylum room. So there's the walls are all padded. I'm just bunking up with my parents for the summer, and where I'm in my basement right now in my bedroom. So we have the radiator heating is coming over, so it gets nice and warm on the cool nights in Canada. So there's my clarification.
I just wanted to clarify, because someone's going to put in the comments, where is Jake right now with that display?
I'm in a nuclear bunker underground, deep underground.
So what is the plan for the rest of the summer? Have you got anything big coming up apart from keeping fit and getting yourself in shape for the upcoming season?
Yeah, I don't know. Just hang out with friends, hang out with family. I know this might ruffle some feathers, but my good buddy Lucas Bryan is coming to visit me here for a big country music rodeo festival here we have in Calgary. So he's going to come visit me for that. And golf, maybe go see some mountains, go do some outdoorsy stuff. Maybe not, I don't know. But just golf, train, skate, and just get ready for the season.
Yeah, I'm sure Dundee fans will have a warm welcome for Lucas next season, but you can prepare them for that as you're listening to country music. Who's the big names at the country festival you're at?
So the big name, the big festival that I'm going to, or the concert that I'm going to, is actually not country. So I'll briefly explain it. So it's downtown Calgary. There's a rodeo. It's the largest purse, biggest rodeo in the world. And then there's a fairgrounds that goes around it. And then there's a bunch of tents that have different concert venues. There's country bars, country tents, EDM tents, whatever. So I'm going to John Summit on the Wednesday of the event. So that's the one I'm big looking forward to. That should be an interesting night. So I'm excited for that one.
Yeah. Keep Lucas safe while you're there. I'm sure
we'll know that. I will. Stars fans, or maybe I might hurt his ankle just before the season starts. I don't know.
Yeah, do some sabotage work. Why don't you? That sounds good. Have you got a final message for the Stars fans before we wrap it up, Jake?
I'm excited for the season. I'm excited to see all the familiar faces floating around the ranks. So, I'm excited to be back. I'm excited to be a Star again. And I'm really looking forward to the season started. So, see you at the DIA.
Indeed, we will. Season tickets on sale now. DundeeStars.com for all information on that. Jake, I'll love to see you there for every game if you can make it next season, like I would and everybody else at the Stars. Jake, enjoy the festival. Keep Lucas safe. Maybe do a bit of sabotage on him before he leaves. That's nasty. I shouldn't say that. Yeah,
keep him safe. We'll blur that.
Yeah, we'll blur that. Yeah, keep him safe. And hey, listen, and we will catch up with you in August, September, when everything all kicks off and we're getting ready for that 24-25 season.
Unreal, Swanee. Well, I'll see you then.